Welcome. Let us discuss some extensions in Google Chrome. One of the extension is Grid View. We can download it from the Google App Store. Grid View allows us to view all the participants that have joined in our session. As such, when we use the settings and change the layout, by default, our tiled view shows maximum number of participants, that is 16. Using Grid View, we can see all the participants, and it has some additional options. As participants join the sessions, it will automatically resize them to fit all the participants as a grid. Some of the options of Grid View are: show only participants with video. This will show participants that have turned on their videos. Highlight the speaker. Whenever somebody is speaking, then it will highlight it using a rectangle. Include yourself in the grid, who is conducting the meeting or is the presenter. He or she will also be included. Enable Grid View by default. If you choose this option, then session will start with Grid View enabled. Our objective is to see all the participants, and Grid View can help us in doing this. Another important extension is Meet Attendance Collector. This will help us in taking the attendance of our session. What we can do is, we'll click whenever the session is going on, we have to just click on the Meet Attendance Collector extension. Again, we can download it from Google Chrome App Store. And what we have to do is, we have to click on the refresh button. Once we have clicked on the refresh button, it will collect all the participants, and then we click on download. So this will generate an Excel file showing us the details of the participants. So this way we can easily collect the attendance of our session. Another option is Google Meet Auto Admit. So this helps us in reducing our time to allow the participants to our session. They can automatically join the session without any delay. This will also help us in allowing our authorities to join our session without any delay. There are many apps in the Google Apps button, the 9 dots here in the right hand side of the web browser. We are using Google Meet for our video sessions, and some of us are also using Google Classroom. One more thing I would like to discuss here today: we have a Google Calendar where we can easily schedule our meetings. The only thing that we have to do is, whenever we want to schedule a meeting, we just click on the time schedule. For example, suppose these are the schedules that I have already done to take the classes which are weekly in nature. So I have already scheduled classes for 12th computer science and MCC class and IT class, and again 12th computer science. Okay, so for to schedule any event, simply you have to click on the particular time of the day. For example, suppose that I have some class at say 10 to 10:40, then I'll click here and I'll give a title, say my class, whatever class you have, and then the time. So suppose I want to change the time from 10 a.m. to 10:45. Okay, then does not repeat. Suppose I want to repeat it weekly on every Wednesday, then I select on every Wednesday. And suppose I want to have a session on add Google Meet video conferencing, I click on that. So it will provide you with a link. You can copy the link and you can send it to the person. You can save it, remind you of the class that you have. This link, we can use it anytime. It will remind you before the class begins every week, so you don't have to remember. Also, once scheduled, you can take it for every class. The same link will be available at a later time on the next week. You just click on this and you click on the link or copy the link and again use it. So this also helps you to use the same link again. Another feature, the Jamboard. We can use the Google Jamboard as a whiteboard. For the first time, you need to create whiteboard, blank whiteboard by clicking on New Jam, the plus button on the bottom right corner. This will open a blank Jamboard. We can use pen, choose any color and then anything that we want to like, say computer science, I want to have CS class. You can use it like this, or you can clear the frame, or you can write anything and clear using it. Is just like we are using other options, so we can use it as a whiteboard. Select or note, you want to give some note, you can change the colors to customize according to your need. So a note will be added. Okay, then we can also change the position of the note from one point to another point. You can insert any image. And move it to anywhere. You can also use laser to highlight whatever you want to show. Similarly, once done, you can either clear frame or you can increase or decrease the size. You want to keep this and you need more. You click on this on to the right side, create a new frame, and you can add a new frame to your Jamboard. This way we can use the Jamboard as a whiteboard, and once done you can save this as an image, or you can download as PDF or rename it. I haven't named it, so I can rename it as okay, and then this is the three dots for having different actions. Or we can make a copy, or we can remove this from here. So this is how we can use the Google Jamboard as our whiteboard while taking sessions in Google Meet. Thank you.